Mr. Jain, one question before everybody starts.
Right, sir. Tell me.
Is it that Mr. Gadkari says that still there are some changes going to come in this MSME notification?
MSME definition, they have already changed as per the investment pattern.
Right.
That is already done.
But they say that this turnover limit is likely to go up. He has given some statement.
Not on the basis of turnover, but on the basis of investment now. Because turnover, you know, if the turnover is the criteria, then many MSME will lose the status.
Hello. Exactly.
So I think they are going to remove this criteria of turnover. Rather, it will be on investment basis.
That is the right thing to do.
Yes, that's why industry have approached to them that keep it on the criteria should be on the investment wise, not turnover wise.
And this is again to be passed by the parliament?
It is yet to be passed.
So we are discussing just whatever is at present available in the text.
Yes, yes. Whatever format is there for MSMEs that we are discussing on
that. Yes, I will shutting out.
Because basically, today's topic is
password, sir?
Government stimulus package and how the MSME is going to benefit or whether it is useful or not.
Very correct.
Right. Uh-huh. In the morning, Dr. Sen Gupta of SIS also arranged this webinar on the same topic. Mm-hmm. And when I spoke over there about you have to elaborate. I'll just say a line or two about MSMEs impact on MSMEs about this government stimulus package.
I appreciate it.
बाकी आपको बिपिन भाई इंडस्ट्री का सीन क्या लगता है से अनदर फ्रॉम 2 टू 3 फ्रॉम मंथ्स फ्रॉम नाउ
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नो द फर्स्ट थिंग फर्स्ट इज दैट व्हेन आर वी कमिंग कंपैरेटिवली आउट फ्रॉम दिस कोरोना वायरस एंड देन व्हाट इज द टाइम फ्रेम वेयर बाय विल अचीव नॉर्मलसी इन द इंडस्ट्री ऑफ कोर्स इफ आस पर्सनली आई थिंक वी आर इन द बेस्ट ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री बिकॉज pharma is going to flourish only with the way
that's right
the healthcare importance is increasing in the country
right
but barring that there are few industries which are really in difficulty like tour and tourism and aviation industry even real estate these are going to find very rough weather for next 1.5 to 2 years it looks like
hospitality and aviation I think there will not be less than 50%
survival so,
survival 50% drop in this that is going to be there and because see still that retrenchment in the aviation sector is going on rather it is just started when last week Emirates retrenched 30,000 staff
right oh,
30,000 staff Emirates airline which is world's one of the biggest airline and most rich airline
when big okay. airline sir
Emirates
yes
30,000. You can imagine what will be the impact on the life of these people, and so the economy of consumer sector and all that is going to have very adverse effect all over.
But is it correct that we read in newspaper that even the unemployment in India has gone from 7 to 27%?
7 to 27. Maybe they must have taken this 2 months record. During that lockdown period when people are sitting idle, they must have taken that into consideration. It is not the real unemployment. It is people sitting idle because of closed down.
So
they must have taken that into consideration that people are sitting because factories are not running due to lockdown. So there some correction is required, I think.
Fine. So it's a matter of time. After some months, we'll know
right.
the real unemployment rate.
Right, right.
But people are really very scary. There is a lot of fear psychosis.
Very, right. Very scary. One or the other type, business people have got business impact on business. Service class is scary when they can lose the job. And it's a very pathetic situation.
Sometimes even at our higher level, we feel that it's better to read less newspapers. Read newspaper and you again feel more scary, more depressed. So if you right. don't read, sometimes you are better off.
No, actually, in the evening hours, we have stopped watching news nowadays. Because all same day's figures, they say, read it in the evening news also.
Right.
Yeah, and it's all very depressing.
Correct. Very correct, sir.
Aneshan ji.
Anji.
Mr. Hello? Ashish Ved is going to be there.
Yeah, he just called me. He's joining.
So he's going to give the address.
No address.
No
address.
Ashish.
No. Ashish. Namaste.
Welcome.
Ashish. Namaskar.
So Ashish, let Ashish bhai say welcome address, na?
No.
So I saw him. That's the reason I asked.
I just came. I came flying from Subhash Desai's meeting. I should change the backdrop actually, no?
Yeah, now you have to change it.
How do you change it now while it's on?
Good evening, Ashish.
Good evening.
Click.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Click on the arrow, stop video. There you will get the virtual background settings.
Where is it?
Thanks.
No, I'm not getting it.
On stop video, see, there is an arrow.
Yeah. Stop video. There's an arrow.
Click on that arrow.
Close
you get to choose the virtual background.
Yes.
Just thank go there and
thank
see.
Thank you.
Where is the virtual background?
Virtual background, you'll have to select one of the virtual backgrounds.
Wide screen. Camera, my video, meetings.
No. Stop video, Hannah. Stop video. Stop video.
Oh, yeah, I know. I've gone to that.
On that arrow, you
I've done that.
Then choose setting. Virtual background. Not setting is the first one. Usme choose virtual background. Hai.
Achha, aur
one
bhi
of the hai. Options.
Okay, let me check. Let me check.
Yeah. Hey, Chandra, you become Santa Claus.
Yeah. Yes, choose
I'll
virtual
start.
Background.
I'll lovely. Start.
Yeah.
Okay. Before we start, as usual, I'll just explain the rules to everybody. All are requested to go onto the speaker view, which is on the right-hand side corner of your screen. Do not be in the gallery view because speaker view gives you a better experience of the VC. Then all the participants, I'll be force muting y'all so that there is no disturbance during the commencement of the panel discussion. So post the panel discussion, when the question answer session starts, I'll be giving you the access to mute and unmute yourselves. Before that, you won't be able to unmute yourselves. Only the speakers will be able to control because I'm giving them the control. Okay. So just a minute, everybody, I'll be muting all of y'all. So just give me 1 minute. Okay, I have unmuted Mr. Suresh, S. Suresh, Mr. Kannan, and Mr. Bipin Shah. So y'all can control your mute and unmute now. Plus I have unmuted Mr. R.K. Jain. So can we start off, sir?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So good afternoon to all. On behalf of the IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industry, we welcome all the speakers and dignitaries to the online seminar on decoding government stimulus package for MSMEs. As we begin the session, I request Mr. Shri R.K. Jain, Chairman, IMC Navi Mumbai Committee, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Selby. Yeah. Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
On behalf of IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industry, I would like to welcome you all and my special welcome to the panelists of today's event, Mr. R. Kannan, Head Corporate Performance Management, Hinduja Group, Mr. S. Suresh, Branch Manager, National Small Industries Corporation Limited, Mr. Bipin Shah, President, Thane Belapur Industry Association. Today's topic is decoding government stimulus package for MSME. Friends, I personally feel that government has done enough for MSME during recently announced package. But MSME in India face different kind of problems. I would like to just narrate in 2-3 lines the kind of problems they have been facing, not only post-COVID, but in the normal circumstances while running day-to-day business. See, MSME in India depends on corporate sector or big industries to source their raw material and again to supply their finished product. And while doing so, they have to extend liberal credit to the big industries for supplying their finished product. And while sourcing the raw material, they have to either give advance payment or payment against delivery. This really upsets the funding position of MSME in our country. Now, the sudden lockdown, which was announced on 21st of March, that was financial year end for the trade and industry. And during the financial year end, any trade and industry maintains very low inventory of raw material as well finished product. And this is what has happened, that while maintaining the lowest inventory, suddenly industry was to close the operations. Gradually, when mid-April or say first week of May, when gradually industry started resuming, they found that they don't have the raw material available to start the production, and they don't have anything in the ready stock to supply to their clients. And then they realized that during these 2 months time or 1.5 months time, all their receivables were held up because of this lockdown, which they were supposed to receive from their clients. Many MSMEs, they don't operate from their own premises, but from the leased and rented premises. Although the operations were not happening, but still the rentals were piling up. The interest on term loan and working capitals were piled up in the banks, and they did not have any money to cater to these requirements. Looking to all these aspects, Government of India has announced some packages for MSMEs, and the one package was moratorium for the EMIs of term loan or working capital or on the housing loan. Now, I feel that this deferment of the EMIs was a very temporary or very minuscule kind of relief, because it's a kind of deferment or postponement of their liabilities for a few months, and later on liability will come with bigger liabilities by way of more interest liability. Another package was collateral guarantee free loan for the MSMEs. I have been contacting my bankers, and I feel still even the nationalized banks have not received any communication from Government of India, the procedure and certain things, how to disburse this loan. Although documentation is ready, but banks are not advised by the government how to disburse these loans to MSME. So still that is still pending. Now, these are the things which MSME have been facing. Although experts are there, they will elaborate on these issues. From my side, I have just said on these two lines about on this today's topic. And there are many first time participants of today's IMC, this webinar. So I would like to just give brief introduction about IMC to them. Friends, IMC is 113-year-old business chamber, having its headquarters in South Bombay. We have more than 2,500 members and 220 trade and industry associations as our affiliate members. We represent 4,000 business and industry establishment from diverse sect of industry. IMC has signed 150 MOUs with various chambers world over. we deal with all the consul generals of various countries to promote bilateral trade. We have a branch in Navi Mumbai, in New Delhi, and in Andheri. In Navi Mumbai, we represent all sects of trade and industry because Navi Mumbai is hub of wholesale commodity markets and a large industrial base. We represent all these industries and commodity markets in Navi Mumbai. So this was my brief introduction about IMC. Now I would like to hand over this to the moderator.
As we start the panelists, I would just give a brief an overview into who are the panelists. Basically, our panelists consist of three members: Mr. R. Kannan, Head Corporate Performance Management, Hinduja Group Management Consultant and key member of corporate in TCS, Hinduja Group, ICICI Bank. The second panelist is Mr. S. Suresh, Branch Manager, the National Small Industries Corporation Limited, a Government of India enterprise. The third panelist would be Mr. Bipin Shah, President, Thane Belapur Industry Association. And this panel would be moderated by Mr. G. Chandrasekhar, Director, IMC ERTF, Economist, who will be moderating the session. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Selby. Such a delight for me to be here. I want to thank Jain sir for the introductory remarks. And I'm truly delighted IMC President Ashish Vaid has joined. I saw him. Welcome, Mr. President. This is an important event, important webinar. I want to compliment Ganeshan for organizing this and getting more than 100 participants, the first proposition. Let me a little background about the MSME sector. Of course, all of us know about this, but yet to set the ball rolling, I want to mention that the MSMEs, micro, small and medium enterprises, are the backbone of India's economy. There are about 6.3 crore MSMEs operating in our country, which is 63 million operating in our country. They employ as many as 11 crore people, which is about 110 million people are employed in these sectors. And of course, MSMEs contribute to as much as 30% of our exports. And therefore, it's a significant sector for our economy. We call this small and medium. In my opinion, individually, the sector may be small, made up of small units, but taken together, when you aggregate, MSME is small no more. MSME is really big from a country's GDP contribution perspective. Now, after this lockdown following COVID-19, announced on what? I think March 25th. Today, is we have just about the 10th week of the lockdown. The whole country is virtually immobilized. Economic activities have by and large come to a standstill. Factories are closed. Transport services are disrupted. Foreign trade has shrunk. Both import and export trade has shrunk. Global value chains have got substantially disrupted. There are huge job losses. Without any doubt, we cannot feign that there are no job losses at all. There are job losses because a number of manufacturing units and service units are closed with a certain risk about their revival. There's a huge amount of reverse migration. For I think the situation is really scary. CRISIL has recently come up with a projection for 2021, which says our economy will shrink. There'll be a minus 5% shrinkage. The pandemic has affected not only human health, which is scary, but also it's affected and it continues to affect economic health of this nation. And the impact of the economic health is possibly far greater than many of us can actually imagine. Therefore, in my opinion, on current reckoning, given the way we are able to contain this pandemic, the number of cases, etc., and the lockdown, we are probably into lockdown 5.0. It's going to take several quarters. It's going to take a long time for our country, probably several quarters for any meaningful recovery. And if there is any one sector which can actually lead this recovery in economic activity of this country, in addition to agriculture, it is the MSME sector. Earlier this month, the government of India, the finance minister, came up with a series of stimulus package. And usually, we have seen during economic crisis, most governments announce a stimulus package. And these stimulus packages are usually of three types. What are the three types? One is the fiscal stimulus. Second is monetary expansion. Third is administrative relief. So the government of India has given a lot of administrative relief. There is no doubt at all. They have also expanded the monetary policy or monetary policy substantially more accommodative than it was earlier. But from a fiscal stimulus perspective, we are yet to see any significant relief or reduction or change. But that's another matter, because the government also will have to look at the fiscal space available for it to give substantial fiscal relief. Now, very quickly, of course, Jain Saab mentioned, let me recapitulate what he said. For the MSMEs, the stimulus package includes a 3 lakh crore emergency working capital facility for businesses, including MSMEs. Okay, it's for all businesses, including MSMEs. And this is a collateral-free automatic loan for standard MSMEs. Loan tenure is 4 years with a moratorium of 12 months for principal repayment. No fresh collateral or guarantee fee. 100% credit guaranteed by the Government of India, for whom this will become a contingent liability in the government's balance sheet. If these loans have to be availed before 31st of October. And there are some estimates which suggest that this package, this 3 lakh crore package, is most likely to benefit about 45 lakh units. Remember, there are 6.3 crore units in the country. But this package is most likely to help less than 10% of those units. Then we also have the 20,000 crore subordinate debt for stressed MSMEs. This, it is estimated that about 2 lakh MSME units, which are currently NPAs or are substantially stressed, are likely to benefit. 50,000 crore equity infusion for MSMEs has been proposed through fund of funds for units that have potential and viability. How, who will judge and how the viability and the potential of the units, who will judge, whether the bankers will judge, and how, what are the criteria that they will use, is a little less clear at this point of time. Also, more important is there's no global tender for government tenders up to 200 crores, which in my view is a very positive step. The intention is that the government of India and all its tenders will buy exclusively from domestic MSME units. And then importantly, there's a new definition for MSMEs with investment limit revised upward and introduction of an additional criterion, which is of course the turnover. And the distinction between manufacturing and services has been removed. And therefore, the new definition, in my view, is going to allow MSMEs to attain scale over a period of time. It's positive. But at the moment, they actually enjoy the benefits, all the benefits that a small unit is given by the policy. And therefore, once they are allowed to scale up, hopefully, they will outgrow their current stature, which I think they must attend. It is in this background that we have such a wonderful panel of experts to tell us about very specific issues that the MSME sector is facing. How will the stimulus package help MSMEs? How do MSMEs propose to tackle post-lockdown challenges?
after all, this lockdown is not forever. It has to come to an end. Maybe by June, maybe July, we don't know. Hopefully, God forbid, it should not go into July. Maybe 31st May, we don't know. And therefore, it's not going to go on forever. Therefore, units have to start looking at post-lockdown activities. So how are they? What are the challenges? The challenge is labor availability. The challenge is cash flow. What about receivables? What about debts? And of course, inventory management, both raw material inventory and finished product inventory. How would these units get back into the supply chain? And importantly, all the SMEs and small and medium enterprises, if they want to raise capital through equities, what will they have to do? These are questions that have been, I'm sure, bothering a lot of people. We have a fantastic panel of experts, and therefore, I want to now start with Mr. Kannan from the Hinduja Group. Kannan, you can share your thoughts with all the participants. In the first round of conversation, let each panelist have about 10 to 12 minutes, and then we'll probably have a round of follow-up questions, etc. Kannan, the floor is yours.
Thank you. Should I make the presentation?
Please.
Good evening to all of you. So, 1 minute.
I'll just give you the rights.
Oh, screen sharing. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Done. So, done? It's on.
Has it done? Yeah.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Good afternoon to all of you.
Afternoon.
So this crisis actually it started with a kind of a health crisis. It got converted into a kind of a financial crisis, now economic crisis. Slowly it is developing into a social crisis. So that is the unemployment, people moving out and all that. So after the last financial crisis in 2008.
Excuse me, sir. Just a minute. Can you put it in the presentation mode?
Presentation mode?
Yeah, the PPS mode, the screen mode.
Oh, 1 minute.
Yeah.
Has it come now?
Yeah. Correct.
Yeah,
now it's perfect.
Perfect? Yeah.
Continue, sir.
So what happened in this crisis? Last time when the crisis happened, India was in a very strong position. We were growing very fast. In fact, 2008 crisis didn't affect India much. We continued to grow till 2011 March at a faster pace. Of course, there were some stimulus measures. But during this crisis, what has happened? Even before this crisis, 7-8 quarters, India, we have seen a lower GDP growth. GDP growth was coming down quarter by quarter. And our Indian government started announcing stimulus measures from the month of September. If you remember, the finance minister and her team, they started talking about stimulus measures from September onwards. So even before the crisis, actually we had a mini crisis within India, where many of the sectors in India became very uncompetitive. Companies were not able to utilize their capacity well. And like other governments, based on the last experience, other governments in the world were very, very fast to react. They went and announced stimulus measures, which were ranging from 10 to 30% of GDP. Today, if you look at Japan, including the measure they announced, it is close to 40% of GDP. Indian government was also very fast. Immediately, they went and announced some fiscal measures worth some 170,000 crores. After the lockdown, first lockdown only, we started realizing what will be the impact of lockdown. So after every lockdown, when it was announced, when IMF projected India's economic growth at the end of March at 1.9%, from then onwards, today, the projection for economic growth has come down to minus 5% to minus 10%. In fact, day before yesterday, CRISIL, then Fitch and SBI, all of them downgraded the economic growth to 5%. So in this background, let us see what is SME funding. What is the status of SMEs in India? What are the measures announced by the government? How SMEs can avail these schemes? So what is the strategies they have to follow? So as it was clearly mentioned, I will not elaborate the first slide, but it was already discussed. 30% of our GDP comes from MSMEs today. And in terms of merchandise exports, SMEs almost contributed 48% in the financial year 19, almost close to 50%. And there are 6.34 crore unincorporated non-agricultural MSMEs, and they provide employment to 1.1 crore people. And if you look at the breakup, 31% MSMEs are in manufacturing, 36% in trade, and 33% in other services. This is in line with the contribution of GDP. Services is 58%, and we have industry and manufacturing at 27-28%, and remaining 16-17% by agriculture. And if you look at about 3.24 MSMEs are really in rural area, and 309 lakh MSMEs are in urban area. And government has set an objective to increase the contribution of MSMEs of GDP to 50%. Right now it is only 30%. So that is why government, most of the measures they announced, it is all relating to MSMEs. And at the end of January, if you look at the total loans in the Indian context, there are about 64 lakh crores which has been given to corporates and MSMEs. Out of that, 17.8 lakh crores of loans are availed by MSMEs. And if you look at the share of NBFCs in MSME lending, 12.5%. So the latest survey, which was done by SIDBI as well as TransUnion CIBIL, what they are saying is that if you look at some of the statistics which they are saying, the small micro units, which are less than 10 lakhs, they have a borrowing of 88,000 crores. This survey came out only 2-3 days ago. And if you look at micro, which is 10 lakhs to 50 lakhs, these units have borrowed 2,17,000 crores. And if you look at micro to 50 lakhs to 1 crore, they have borrowed 1,46,000 crores. Then small, which are between 1 crore to 5 crore, they have borrowed 8,72,000 crores. And medium units between 15 crores to 50 crores, they have borrowed 4,51,000 crores. So the units which are between 1 crore to 15 crores, they have borrowed the maximum. They borrowed the maximum amount. Are you able to see the presentation? Hello?
No, sir.
It's gone blank.
Yeah, it's gone blank.
Gone blank, is it? One minute.
Just reload it.
Reload it, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Has it come now?
No, sir. Oh. You'll have to close it again.
Now it's come.
Yes, it's come.
So, in terms of who has lent to these MSMEs, public sector banks, 49.8%. Private sector banks, 37.6%. And NBFCs, 12.5%. So one more survey which they have done, according to the surveys, 60% of MSMEs in India, their liquidity position is good and their financials are good, and they will be able to face this kind of crisis. And other statistic is that 30% of MSMEs in India, they are really very strong. So they will be able to withstand this crisis. And coming to overall measures, of course, the government announced about 20 lakh crores. Out of that, if you calculate, the actual outgo from government and RBI is only 1.2% of the total measures they announced so far. So most of that incentives which they have given, it is all through banks, it is all through NABARD, it is all through financial institutions and NBFCs. So that is how they have structured the measures so far. I'll just run through the measures. As it was mentioned earlier, there is a collateral free loan of 3 lakh crores. Now they have clarified, government has clarified, it is not only MSME, whoever is having an outstanding loan as of 29th February 2020, 25 crore outstanding, up to 25 crore of outstanding in a bank or in an NBFC, they are eligible to avail this facility. So what is the calculation when they say 20%? The government has assumed that out of that 17.5 lakh crores availed by MSMEs, at least the 15 lakh crores borrowing, they are eligible for additional funding. So you don't require to give any proof that why you want this 20%. There was a question raised earlier. So what will be the basis of this 20%? You need the MSME has to have just to have a outstanding, the maximum of 25 crores. So they will get a maximum exemption of loan by another 5 crores without asking any question. So that is immediately available to them. And again, there is a question, banks, they are not aware how to do it, but already they have got a guideline from the Credit Guarantee Corporation, and they have to sign a kind of agreement with the corporation to say that yes, we will be lending. These are the kind of MSMEs we have. This is the outstanding loan we have with MSMEs. So we will be giving additional loan of 20% to them. And based on that, the credit guarantee will be given by the corporation. So only now it is in the court of the banks to sign the agreement with the guarantee corporation. And once they've signed with all the statistics, they have to sign the bond. Once it is done, it is available. So it will be a term loan at a concessional rate of interest, as you are all aware. So only 9% plus from the banks, and they allow, that is the maximum. And NBFCs, since they are also a major lender, they can take the interest rate to 14%, because the cost of funding of NBFCs is much higher compared to banks. Then there is a scheme for credit enhancement. So 100% credit guarantee will be given to banks. So the MSMEs, they don't require to give any additional collateral or guarantee. Yesterday or day before, the government clearly clarified, when they say MSME, they need not be covered under any of the MSME schemes as of today, even if any small unit which are not covered under any of these MSME schemes, but they are operating in a sector like hotel, airline, accommodation, and their maximum borrowing is only 25 crores, they are eligible to avail this scheme. So it is not just restricted to the defined MSMEs. So this is available till 31st October. This is available from 23rd of May. And this should enhance ability of banks and NBFC to lend. So the banks and NBFCs, they need not worry about lending this money, because they get the credit guarantee. So it will improve the overall quality of lending. The banks don't require to allocate capital for this lending. Then in the beginning, the government's own outgo will be nil. And according to one of the calculations by State Bank of India, they expect out of these 3 lakh crores, which will be given, maximum which will be turned into NPAs will be about 50,000 crores or 60,000 crores, which means the cost to the government for every year will be maximum only 10,000 crores. Then, this is all for, this scheme is only for MSMEs which are rated investment grade, and that level 0 and level 1 as per the NPA norms. Then government said that there are some MSMEs which are not in that category, but by injecting funds, they will be able to survive and grow. So for that, the government has created a subordinate debt of 20,000 crores. And it's targeting about 2 lakh MSMEs, which are already in a stress situation. And they have become already a non-performing asset. And MSMEs that are stressed, NPAs, promoters of such MSMEs will be lent by banks. Loan shall be infused into the company by promoters as equity. So they are already in a debt. If they are going to borrow more, they will not be able to pay interest. And plus, it will again burden the company. So with the view, instead of inducting in the form of a loan, it will be inducted in the form of a equity with the maximum limit of 75 lakhs. So the for credit enhancement, the government will provide 4,000 crores. For that, they have already advised this CGT MSC. They also sent guidelines to the banks. So this will protect MSMEs which show signs of being able to revive. They are categorized as NPA. This will also protect jobs and prevent insolvencies. The lending by banks will have to be more careful and measured so that the problem is addressed and not merely postponed. And you all know about a company called National Infrastructure Investment Fund, which was created by India. It's an Indian government owned fund. It is called a fund of fund to fund infrastructure. So the fund has created many funds where sovereign wealth funds like Abu Dhabi Investment Authority or Dubai Investment Authority or Canada Pension Fund, these people come and invest to invest in infrastructure. So the government is planning to create a fund of funds for MSME on the similar lines of National India Infrastructure Fund. So this fund itself will not be having 50,000 crores. So this will have a corpus of only 10,000 crores. This will be a holding fund that will create a lot of subsidiary funds where the investors from Japan, investors from US, investors from Norway, investors from Middle East, they'll come and invest to be online or an entity like World Bank or International Finance Corporation. They all will fund this fund of funds. So they'll be able to raise 50,000 crores. So this will be in the form of a public-private partnership, and it will promote cooperation between various stakeholders and investors. So you'll be able to attract funds from.
Sir, just a minute. Mr. Yeah. Chandrasekhar here would like to pitch in.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
If you don't mind, in about 2 or 3 minutes, quickly tell the participant. They're all keen to know. Much of this is, of course, publicly available, these numbers. But what is important is, for example, the sovereign guarantee for the loan means that bankers hopefully will now be less worried about lending to MSMEs. Is that understanding right?
Yes, yes, right.
Because the bankers, that's the kind of, what should I say, assurance or consolation that participants want.
Yeah, yeah,
will
that is
bankers
true.
Be too strict? Will they continue to be strict, or will they be a little lenient because it is finally, there is a sovereign guarantee by the government? I think those are the kind of issues I think we need to actually
talk about. So I'll come to that. So bankers are really...
But you have another 2 or 3 minutes actually wind up. Yeah.
Yeah. So bankers will be very, very comfortable. In fact, like you said, it is a guarantee, plus they are also being advised. And as I said, they are also being protected because whatever they lend right now, and it will not be taken for their capital adequacy norm. Plus, if it goes bad also, it will be treated as a separate account. They will maintain a separate account for this lending. So that will be ring-fenced from their general level of operation. And one more comfort is that the general level of NPA in the MSME sector is very low compared to large corporates. So it's a comfortable for banks. And coming to what is that MSME should do in the next 2-3 minutes.
Yeah.
One is this, as I said, already 30% of MSMEs are very, very strong today. and 60% will be able to face this. So what is that they have to focus? One is this, they should focus on how they can survive in the next just 3-4 months, and liquidity. They have to make sure that they always have the liquidity which is required. And second is that they have to review the costs which are part of their system, and whichever costs which may not be required for their core operations, they should try and reduce the cost. And they have to, many of the MSMEs, they are either suppliers or distributors for large companies. So they have to work very, very closely with all these stakeholders, and they have to manage the cash flow management should be the top priority, and they should study all the schemes. In fact, in this presentation, I have given a very elaborate presentation. Whoever is participating, the presentation can be circulated to them. They can study this in detail. So they can identify the schemes which will be applicable to their own area of operation. And every day some announcement is coming on MSMEs. So you have to closely monitor what they are saying. In fact, they are likely to increase the definition limits of upper limit for how you define MSME. So that is bound to happen. So you have to, then you make a plan to avail the scheme, and you have to avail the scheme to the help of your auditor, of your consultant. And I'm sure, like Mr. Chandrasekhar said in the beginning, MSMEs like agriculture will be able to come back much faster than the large corporates. So that's how I want to end. And maybe at a later point in time, if there are any specific questions, I would be able to answer. Right. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, Kannan, for this presentation, elaborate presentation, very interesting. A lot of facts in this. One quick question before even I start the next panelist. I want to your thoughts. Is this package good enough for the revival of the MSME sector?
Okay, so only from the point of view of MSME, this is a good package. But of course, as we are hearing from the Minister for MSME, there are about 5 lakh crores which are
pending. Yes. Yes.
Across many government institutions.
Correct.
So the first thing the government should do, apart from this package, is they should go and clear this 5 lakhs as soon as possible. Maybe if you ask me, they said 45 days is too much, and they should try and clear it in maybe next 15 days, not 45 days. That is one thing which they have to do. Second is, just giving schemes to MSMEs are not enough. So many of the MSMEs are depending on very large companies.
Correct.
The large companies are the ones which are controlling the entire value chain of industries. So unless the large companies start doing well, there is no scope that MSMEs will do well.
Right.
So there is a need. My feeling is that the next 15-20 days, both the RBI governor and finance minister said, they are closely watching every sector, what is happening there.
Yeah.
They are likely to come up with packages for airlines, accommodation,
right.
Construction, real estate, manufacturing, and automobile.
Yeah.
So once that happens to large companies, then large companies will be able to support MSMEs. Oh, so it is not just MSMEs alone.
Okay.
So they require support from large corporates, as well as for the government in terms of disbursements.
All right. Thank you. Thank you, Kannan. Thank you. I'm now going to invite Bipin Bhai Shah, President, Thane Belapur Industries Association. Bipin Bhai, are you there? You are in the hot seat. You are in the hot spot. You are in the midst of all the action. Very large number of MSMEs in the Thane Belapur industrial area, and I'm sure you know all the problems the units are discussing with you. Please share with our members, IMC members, your thoughts on the adequacy of these this stimulus package. How is it going to help? Any guidance or advice that you have for MSMEs? Yeah, sir.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chandrasekhar. Am I audible to everybody?
Yes,
yes,
to
sir.
Me, yes.
Yes.
So first of all, I think the kind of percentage that were given by the earlier speaker, that we have 30% of the MSME which are in good shape, and 50% can survive this coronavirus.
Yeah.
Whereas coincidentally, I am in industry for the last 48 years, and I had been visiting various industrial estates, MIDC and GIDC and all that. I have not seen even single industrial estate where the sickness is less than 30%.
That means
30% units are practically closed because they don't consume any water or any electricity.
Right.
So probably, I think on the ground floor, if you see, on the ground, if you see, then percentage of sickness is much higher. That is what is my feeling being a resident of an industry. Secondly, this change of definition, first we thought has come as a big relief because particularly for medium scale, from 10 crores of plant and machinery, they took it to 20 crore. And while listening to the Nirmala Sitharaman or FM, I was under impression that it is either 20 crores or 100 crore turnover. Whereas ultimately the fine print says that it is and 100 crore. So actually, not that more number of units will be enjoying MSME benefits, but some units will go out of MSME benefits. I'll give you a simple example. In plant and machinery, actual production machinery is counted. You don't count land, you don't count building, you don't count other preliminary and pre-operative fixed assets. So when you invest something in the range of 40 to 50 crore, then you will be eligible for remaining within 20 crores of plant and machinery. Now, when anybody invests an amount like 40 to 50 crore, all put together, total cost of the project, ultimately he will definitely need a turnover of more than 100 crore if he has to survive. So probably this definition itself is a little shocking that rather than bringing more people within the range of MSME, it will take substantial people out of the range of MSME, particularly the medium scale. This is my first contention that on the basis of what I know about it. Now coming to this 300 crores, 3 lakh crores, that up to 20% of the outstanding limit as on 29 February, I think this is a very good point. But ultimately what industry needs is not liquidity only. I would like to give one small example. Any product of chemicals or pharmaceuticals, when it is imported from China, the moment you import goods worth of $100, even today, after last two decades, the moment you show the government an invoice of $100, $13 is granted to you as a cash subsidy and it gets deposited into the exporter's account. Now imagine, this is the real challenge of surviving an MSME. Liquidity is one part, but that is only a temporary relief. Ultimately, there has to be profitability in the thing, and now 2 months or 2.5 months, they are going to lose zero business. So is it that the liquidity, probably it will solve, but probably in my considered opinion, it will solve only a smaller problem or a, let us say, temporary problem will be solved. Coming to this subordinate debt for stressed MSME for 20,000 crores, as I understand that government will give only 20% of the guarantee which these people are going to get. So still, there is a hanging sword for the balance amount. The next point, disallowing global tenders to foreign companies. I think, yes, this is a very good point. So this MSME package is a mixed package. Certain things are not viable, but certain things are definitely good. So I would say disallowing global tenders to foreign companies are a definite positive point. Then interest subsidy extended up to 31st March 2021. This also I would like to appreciate that, yes, because the policies has been extended for 1 year, this will help. Then networking for MSME, it's a good point for that e-exhibition, but it will have a very small impression, I think. Now this payment within 45 days, you'll be surprised to know that the moment we go with an MSME certificate to anybody and we say that you'll have to, perforce you have to make payment within 45 days, there are two replies. Will not do that, or will buy from somebody else. So on the contrary, this acts as an hindrance to an industry. This 45 days limit, they say we'll pay on 90 days. If you want, we'll give you a check of 45th date, but you'll have to deposit after 90 days. Now, these are very funny things. You see, people in government do not know what is happening on the ground level. Even in my own company, several times I have been an MSME. When I go to multinational companies, to big Indian companies, They say, okay, thank you, bye-bye. We don't have to buy from you. Now, why nobody sees, this is the reality. And the moment you say you want to enforce on them, they say, okay, we will blacklist you from our suppliers list. Now, this is the absolute reality. Then this equity infusion of about 10,000 crore by government, I don't think it is going to be a starter, because see, there is so much of due diligence to be done for any company who wants this kind of, and then you expect that after government puts in so much money, there will be additional funds available. I somehow feel that this is not very feasible. Then the loan deferment by 3 months. Yes, I think it is very good, because in these 3 months, people will be having tremendous problem of liquidity. And I definitely fully support this. This custom clearance 24/7, I think this is on paper. The way we see, whatever I produce in my company, 50% is exported. And whatever used to take 48 hours is now taking 12 to 15 days to clear one export consignment. And similar time to clear one import consignment. And that also my staff sits there for 1 day, 2 day, 3 days at Nhava Sheva port and other ports. So I think many things which are written here are non-starter. And again, one more important thing, as I know that now they have said that even outstanding should not be more than 60 days. Otherwise, there is some new rule that you cannot avail of that 25 crore which they have fixed up. So there are some, of course, opposition leaders have given a full analysis that 99% of these benefits probably on practical level may not be possible for people to utilize. I don't go by the opposition what they say, because their job is to oppose. But I also feel that it's a typical mixed bag. Probably what they should have done is, again, a direct benefit to somebody so that his survival is not challenged. Liquidity is not something on which you can say that you will survive. Okay, you have a deferred payment scheme, you have some such thing. But probably as an industrialist or as a president of an industrial association, I feel our expectation was much more than that. Thank you very much, Mr. Chandrasekhar.
Mr. Chandrasekhar? Hello, Mr. Chandrasekhar? Yeah, you're unmute,
okay,
sir.
All right. Okay. Thanks, Bipin bhai, but I have questions. The first question is, what do you think MSMEs now will do once the lockdown is lifted? They're going to have a series of issues. Of course, liquidity is one part. Inventory, both raw material inventory and finished product inventory. As you rightly pointed out, the larger corporates to whom the MSMEs are vendors or suppliers, what is going to happen to them? And therefore, how do you see things panning out, assuming that sometime in June, the lockdown is lifted, hypothetically? I'll talk about scenarios at the end of it when I wind up. But assuming sometime in June, the lockdown is lifted, July, August, September, how do you see the MSMEs coming back on track in terms of labor availability, inventory management, cash flow? You think a large number of them will come back to normal business, or what kind of challenges do you think they're going to face? And how will they address the challenge?
Mr. Chandrasekhar, this is industry specific, product specific.
Yeah.
But I feel that a lot of patience will be required for survival. Somebody may take 3 months.
Yeah.
Somebody may take 6 months. Yeah. And I also feel that 10 to 15% will have to close their shops also. Mm-hmm. Although I don't wish so, because as it is, they were not in good shape.
Right.
And this liquidity support probably may not make them stand up again and walk.
But the
only answer I can tell you is it will be product and industry specific. And patience is the name of the game for MSME.
Right, sir. So one more question which has been bothering me. In all these packages, my suspicion, I may be wrong, I'm not in business, I'm only an observer. My suspicion is the micro enterprises are likely to suffer more than small and medium enterprises. Will I be right in this understanding? Am I right? The micro enterprises are going to face a lot more challenges.
See, the government rules are practically same for micro or small or medium.
Right.
Because they don't have that kind of infrastructure.
Okay, right.
So survival of micro, I am also with you that it will be a problem. One has to think big now.
Yeah,
but it's not the right time to think big when you are passing through a number of problems.
Right, right.
But
right.
I am with you on saying that micro's survival will be a challenge. Sir.
And do you have any kind of insider information when the government is likely to clear the outstanding dues for MSMEs? I think the minister talked about 4.5 lakh crores, big money. So any thought, any insider information?
Not, I would never say insider information, but I would say I have in my personal capacity, I'll say government looks like sincere about the words which I read.
All right.
I think they are sincere about doing that.
Okay. All right. Right, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
I'm
a journalist, therefore I always ask this probing question. Okay. Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts. If we have the time, we'll come for one more round of question. Now I'm going to invite Suresh. Is of course from the National Small Industries Corporation, again, a government institution. And I'm sure Suresh has a lot to share with all the participants here. Suresh, the floor is yours.
Namaskar, Chandrasekhar ji. And a very good afternoon to all my co-panelists and MSME viewers. And thank you, IMC, for having me on board on this webinar. See, I personally very much partially agree with Bipin Shah ji ki jo MSME ka definition hai, wo kuch MSMEs ko in kiya hai aur kuch MSMEs ko out kiya hai. That I do agree partially. And as far as jo introductory remarks are Jain saab ka, कि भाई क्रेडिट जो अभी भी डिफिकल्ट है मिलना हर तरीके से फ्रॉम बैंक्स पर्सपेक्टिव फ्रॉम एनबीएफसीज पर्सपेक्टिव दैट इज आल्सो वेरी मच ट्रू व्हिच इज स्टिल अनआंसर्ड एंड आई थिंक ये चलता रहेगा इट रिमेन अनआंसर्ड ओनली इट कैन नेवर टच 100% सो दैट गैप्स आर ऑलवेज देयर आई थिंक वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट गैप्स एंड मूव अहेड ऑल द एमएसएमई यूनिट्स हैव टू मूव अहेड See, as I am representing National Small Industries Corporation, NSIC, as you all know, it's a government institution coming under the Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. Abhi jo announcement, jo stimulus packages, our Honorable Finance Minister and our Honorable Minister of MSME ne bataya hai, usme agar main apne institution ko products ko synchronize karke batana chahunga, ताकि हम एज एन इंस्टीट्यूशन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सपोर्ट वी आर गिविंग टू एमएसएमई व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फैसिलिटेशन वी आर गिविंग टू एमएसएमई थ्रू आवर स्कीम्स इन ए वेरी शॉर्ट स्पैन ऑफ टाइम आई विल कवर एवरीथिंग सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वो डेफिनेशन की बात आई है जो अभी बढ़ा दिया वो भी अभी फाइनल नहीं हुआ जैसे मीडियम में 20 करोड़ का इन्वेस्टमेंट इन प्लांट एंड मशीनरी एंड 100 करोड़ टर्नओवर वो भी अभी चेंज होने का पूरा स्कोप है बिकॉज उसमें 50 करोड़ इन्वेस्टमेंट इन प्लांट एंड मशीनरी और 250 करोड़ का टर्नओवर लेके आने का उनका प्लानिंग है ये बात सच है कि ये हाउ पीपल कैन बी इन दिस अगर आउट भी होते हैं इन कैसे होता है एज यू ऑल नो पब्लिक प्रोक्योरमेंट पॉलिसी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया वेयर एज 25% ऑफ एनुअल प्रोक्योरमेंट हैज टू बी फ्रॉम एमएसएमई ओनली 4% SAST entrepreneurs, of course, out of that 25%. So, jo pehle, those who are into medium, nahi the, aur wo medium 10 crore ka pehle ka investment in plant and machinery tha. To 10 crore mein jo upar gaye, they are not considered as an MSME. So, they cannot participate in the government procurement benefit. Wo nahi le sakte the. Now, when the definition has changed to all that, they also can participate in the government tenders and of course if they are registered with NSIC they are getting EMD exemption that is as you all know that is one of our product so jo hamare sath registration pehle the जो 10 करोड़ के इन्वेस्टमेंट प्लांट एंड मशीनरी में तो भी कैनॉट एबल टू रजिस्टर देम एज ए पॉलिसी, बट नाउ वी कैन रजिस्टर देम, और जो भी 10 करोड़ के ऊपर वाले है वी कैन रजिस्टर देम एज सून एज द गजेट नोटिफिकेशन वी रिसीव, जो हमें गाइडलाइंस आ जाएंगे तो वी कैन स्टार्ट विद दैट. That is as far as the MSME definition is concerned. Of course, you all know कि अभी manufacturing और services को हटा दिया है, एक ही common दोनों को combined कर दिया है और plant and machinery और turnover रखा है. हाँ, इसमें एक question और भी है जो आप लोग को जानना है कि अगर investment जैसे 5 करोड़ है, किसी का investment 5-6 करोड़ हो जाता है और plant and machinery कम रहता है, तो वो दोनों अगर criteria meet करना है वो अलग अलग कैसे होगा, वो दैट इज ऑल गाइडलाइंस नीड्स टू बी रिसीव्ड एज पर द गजट नोटिफिकेशन, देन ओनली वी कैन कमेंट अपॉन इट. इज ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट में अभी फिलहाल यही हमें भी पता है एज एन इंस्टीट्यूशन आल्सो, सो एज सून एज इट कम्स सो दैट विल बी एप्लीकेबल. वो ये प्रपोजल तो चल रहा है 4 साल से, इट इज पेंडिंग फॉर सम रीजन और अदर. आई थिंक इंडस्ट्रियल एसोसिएशन हैव रिप्रेजेंटेड डिफरेंटली फ्रॉम डिफरेंट इंडस्ट्रियल एसोसिएशन, तो कहीं ना कहीं डिले होके ये आकृति लिया है. इसमें होस्ट ऑफ बेनिफिट्स आल्सो देयर एंड नेचुरली कुछ लोग इससे बाहर भी जा रहे हैं, वो भी चांसेस. आई एग्री विद जैन साहब. एंड नेक्स्ट इज ग्लोबल टेंडर्स. एज यू ऑल नो अब 200 करोड़ का नाउ देयर इज नो ग्लोबल टेंडर, डोमेस्टिक एंटरप्रेन्योर कैन पार्टिसिपेट इन, सो दैट इज वन ऑफ द वेरी 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 बेस्ट विच आई लाइक डेट की ग्लोबल टेंडर्स जो डिसअलाउ किया है इंटरनेशनल को 200 करोड़ तक का. नाउ ऑल गवर्नमेंट कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज ओपन फॉर डोमेस्टिक इंडस्ट्री, दैट इज वन ऑफ द बेनिफिट. ओके, नेक्स्ट वी विल गो. एज यू ऑल नो कि अभी हमें जम पोर्टल में रजिस्ट्रेशन करवाना है. जम पोर्टल से आपको पता है जम पोर्टल अभी काफी पॉपुलर हो रहा है, बट स्टिल इवन गवर्नमेंट इंस्टीट्यूशंस आल्सो सो मेनी बाहर से भी ले रहे हैं, इधर से भी ले रहे हैं. 100% मैंडेटरी नहीं हो रहा है, बट आपको मैं एक इंटरनल बात ये बता सकता हूँ कि ऑल पीएसयू इंस्टीट्यूशंस एज वी आर आल्सो पीएसयू, ऑल पीएसयू इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैव बीन डायरेक्टेड, हैव बीन वेरी क्लियरली गिवन डायरेक्शन दैट कि जो भी प्रोक्योरमेंट होगा अब ऑल जो अवेलेबल जम पोर्टल से वो लेंगे. If it is not available on the JEM portal, then only they are allowed to procure from outside the JEM portal. So all the MSMEs are requested, if they are not registered on the JEM portal, aap turant registration karwa lijiye, because now it is mandatory for all PSUs. We have got an internal guidelines on this, and the PMO's office is going to monitor like anything on this. This is one of the best part to JEM portal ki baat hai. So all MSMEs अभी तक जो register नहीं हुए, I suggest to get themselves registered on the JEM portal because all future procurements have been made through JEM portals only. उसका website भी है www.jem.gov.in. Next, the central government and PSUs जो 45 days का, I do agree कि 45 days is still longer, I think, but it is a very good step again. Because आप सभी को पता है आप लोग के पेमेंट्स 100 दिन भी अटके हुए हैं, 90 दिन भी अटके हुए हैं, और विदाउट एनी रीजन भी अटके हुए, विद रीजन भी अटके हुए, तो कहीं ना कहीं ये 45 डेज का जो आप स्ट्रिक्टली इवन वी हैव इंटरनली बीन आस्क्ड कि 45 डेज का कोई पेमेंट पेंडिंग है, अगर है तो मेड इमीडिएटली, अदरवाइज रिपोर्ट इमीडिएटली. सो वी हैव रिपोर्टेड, वी डोंट हैव एनी इवन एज ए पीएसयू वी आर कमिंग अंडर पीएसयू, तो 45 डेज आई थिंक इट इज स्टिल अ गुड रिलीफ. उसको हम उस परस्पेक्टिव से देखना अनिवार्य है कि पहले तो अभी अनआंसर्ड थे, नाउ इट इज एवरीबॉडी इज आंसरेबल, सो यू कैन यू नो गेट द पीपल कॉन्टेक्टेड कि भाई नहीं 45 डेज का है, अगर कोई नहीं भी देता है यू कैन नाउ हैव ए से, यू कैन रिप्रेजेंट दैट मैटर टू द मिनिस्ट्री और द फोरम्स अवेलेबल. नेक्स्ट, ये 3 लाख करोड़ का पैकेज जो डिजाइन किया है, इसमें एज यू ऑल नो अगेन NSIC वी आर ऑल्सो फंडिंग, we are funding against bank guarantee for procurement of raw material. Now we have an additional scheme of bill discounting, jo aapke bills ko hum discount karenge 90-180 days mein aapko hame repayment karna padega, the cycle goes on, which is at 8.5% rate of interest per annum. So bill discounting scheme humne add kiya, aur jo hamare existing funding jo le rahe hain unko hum 20% ka credit line हम उन्हें देने का ओवर एंड अबाउट देयर लिमिट प्लानिंग में है. इसके गाइडलाइंस स्टिल वी हैव नॉट रिसीव्ड, another, I think, 10 to 15 days, we will receive the guidelines. Those who are our existing units and those who are availing our raw material funding, we can help them out for this 20% credit line. जो आप सभी को पता है कि 25 करोड़ तक का आपका टर्नओवर, आपका लोन आउटस्टैंडिंग होना, 100 करोड़ का टर्नओवर होना, ये 4 साल का है. 1 ईयर इज मोरेटोरियम एज यू ऑल नो, और बाकी 1 ईयर आपको इंटरेस्ट भरना पड़ेगा. बाकी जो 36 महीने 3 साल का जो रहेगा, यू हैव टू पे प्रिंसिपल, एंड इस तरह का ये है. सो बिल डिस्काउंटिंग एंड रॉ मटेरियल अगेंस्ट बैंक गारंटी, यू कैन अवेल दैट स्कीम विद अस. वी आर सपोर्टिंग, वी आर फैसिलिटेटिंग इन दैट स्कीम टू ऑल द एमएसएमईस. लेटेस्ट जैसे भी इनकॉर्पोरेट होगा, जो लेटेस्ट गजट आएगा प्लांट एंड मशीनरी का, जो एम्बिट में नहीं, अगर वो भी आया तो अप टू मीडियम वी कैन फंड इन द फंडिंग. और एज फार एज अवर रजिस्ट्रेशन विच गिव्स यू एग्जम्पशन ऑफ ईएमडी, विच गिव्स यू टेंडर सेट फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट, विच गिव्स यू 15% प्राइस प्रेफरेंस ओवर एंड अबव एनी मीडियम एंड लार्ज स्केल इंडस्ट्री इन पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ टेंडर, यू कैन गेट अवेल ओनली अप टू small scale industry. If there is any medium, that is a promotional scheme, we cannot support to medium scale in that particular scheme. So another is, as you all know, we have a B2B portal jahan agar koi MSM unit hamare sath registered hai under business to business portal, so they have having host of benefits. Jo pehle fees tha uska 6000, now we are facilitating 50% fees हमने उसका कर दिया है. अनदर जून तक ये कंटिन्यू रहेगा. जो एक फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट हम दे सकते हैं, अगर एससी एसटी एंटरप्रेन्योर्स है, सो इट इज फुल्ली एग्जेम्प्ट 100% विदाउट एनी पेमेंट ऑफ फी. यू कैन रजिस्टर अंडर बी टू बी पोर्टल, वेयर इन द बेनिफिट्स आर ह्यूज. अगेन यू विल गेट अ नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑल द गवर्नमेंट टेंडर्स. यू विल गेट, यू कैन बाय एंड सेल द प्रोडक्ट ऑन द वेब पेज. यू कैन क्रिएट योर ओन वेब पेज. All the kind of domestic and international tender alerts will be given to you. Technology upgradation information will be given to you, and host of other benefits available in that particular B2B portal. And also, you know, we are giving raw material distribution. As you all know, NSIC is an NBFC and a promotional institution to NBFC. We are registered, we have a license and under RBI, so we are supporting and as an NBFC too, and as an promotional schemes mein hamare raw material distribution bhi hai, jo hum aapko at a concessional rate, we are at a government rate, we are giving to our MSME units raw materials mein. Aaj ke date mein we are supplying cement, we are supplying and distributing bitumen, we are supplying and distributing zinc, we are supplying and distributing aluminium, jo nalco banata hai hum base, jahan aapko 3700 rupees per ton ka discount milega if you buy from us directly then nalco. So host of benefits we are extending to MSME under this raw material distribution scheme as well. So my point is, as an institution, these are the brief support scheme which we are giving to the MSME. So आप जो plant and machinery में जो medium scale के थे, now they can registered with us for getting EMD exemptions and all. And 20% procurement under procurement public procurement policy के अंतर्गत है, that can also be availed by the all the MSME units. This is the brief. I can synchronize my product with the latest government announcement stimulus जो आप कहते हैं. So that's all from my side, and we'll take up the questions if people are still wanted to know more from me. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Suresh, for this wonderful elucidation. Very interesting, very positive. Suresh ji, ek sawal hai. Main gadi gadi sunta hu, bar bar sunta hu logon se ki jo ye GeM registration is a little cumbersome. Is that correct? Is there any plan to simplify it? Or is there any guidance that you can get, give to people?
See, you might be aware of MSME Development Institute, which is placed at Sakinaka.
Okay.
Any representation, if they are under our ministry only. They are under our ministry only, which is in the policy matter as far as GeM portal is concerned.
Yeah.
You can represent them. These are the problems you are facing. And in a unison, when it goes to, naturally, further simplification will naturally will come when all MSMEs on board.
Bilkul, bilkul. Thank you very much. It's very, thank very you, interesting. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Before we start the question answer session, I just want to go back to my panelists, Kannan, Bipin Bhai, Suresh. If you think you have missed out on any point, in the next 1 minute, each one of us can take a minute or a minute and a half to speak about any point that you might have missed. You may have something or you may not have something. Just go ahead, Kannan, if you have anything, remarks from your side.
We are always talking about what are the issues and how to resolve.
Correct.
One other thing is that this crisis also has created a lot of opportunities for MSMEs. So in fact, some of them have already got registered for making all this personal protective equipment and they started doing the work. So while looking at these schemes, MSMEs also should look at what are the opportunities this crisis has created for them and try and see that whether they can enter the business and make it a success. So that is what I wanted to share.
I have one point. Mr. Chandra,
yes, sir. Yes,
one important point which I missed during my talk, that in China I had been visiting very often and I have seen that any industry who becomes sick in China, the change of hands takes place maximum between 1 to 3 months. Within 3 months, a new buyer starts up and going because the land is provided free by the government of China. The finance is provided by Chinese banks with a long moratorium. So changeover, so for a very long time, the way it happens in India, that in the industry getting sick takes 5 to 10 years to change of hands, whether maximum time permitted in China is 3 months. Within 3 months, a new buyer takes place and the industry starts going on.
Just I have one observation.
Thank you, sir. Yeah,
China, everything is controlled by government. So that is one advantage. Plus in China, what happens is the provincial governor has the full power. Whereas we have central government, state government, then we have a district administration, local government. So China, things will be much, much faster compared to India. That's the main reason.
Correct. Exactly. Suresh ji, anything you want to add after you have said something?
No, I think patience only we need because I personally feel that there are some more announcements will be there in another couple of days because situation is, as you all know, worsening day by day and MSMEs, fraternity are all facing huge problems. But it is also the matter of fact that you should all as a group, you should escalate your problems too. Then only the things will really move. So we will have to have little patience to get the avail the benefits. I personally feel so.
Thank you, Suresh ji. I'm getting a lot of questions from people about you, your contact, your coordinates. I'm sure a lot of people are going to bombard you with questions, and they will seek your help. So my request is please help all IMC members. It is extremely important.
My details are available at IMC very much. I always appreciate IMC ki jahan bhi koi programs hote, they invite me. And we are very true. As I again want to keep you one second.
Yeah,
as an institution, we are very open. We are very clear. We will try to facilitate as best as we can. So not government attitude kind, we never behave. So that support we always give as an institution, as an NSICN. So anybody can come to us at any point of time. At any point of time, they can contact us. My mobile number is otherwise available. Otherwise, I will give right now also. I don't have any problem with that. My mobile number I will share personally. They can speak at any moment of time. They really need me.
Ab chat mein dal dijiye. There is a chat mode. Usme aap dal dijiye aapka number so that everybody is able to access it. But thank you very much for this statement from you. It's really good. It's really good. Now we are it's close to 5:20. I will need the last 5 to 7 minutes, 5 minutes in fact, for winding up. and therefore we can have up to 7 or 8 minutes for a question answer session. Selby, would you like to take over and start?
What I'll do is can you all put in the chat that you want to ask a question? So I'll just hand over the I'll unmute you and you can ask the question. I think Shasni wants to question, right? Okay. 1 minute. I saw you typing. That's the reason. Okay, Shasni, you can ask the question.
Hello, everybody. My name is Priya. I am the owner of Shasni Company. I started my business last year. So I was into trading of apparels and garments. So from this year, I started with designers collection. And it is a new brand of my own.
No, I'm so sorry, beta. You need just to be specific. You need to be ask specific. Questions.
Just ask the question.
Okay. Yeah, sorry.
Okay, so how can bank support me if my turnover would be less than 1 lakh? And what would be my, what is your opinion of for me in the market? In terms of demand for my production.
Who is this question?
Who's the question?
Directed.
RK Jain, sir, or anybody who would prefer, who would like to answer my question?
Mr. Jain, I am not able to find
what you. What's the product you talked about?
Textile.
Garment industry. I'm from garment industry.
All right. I understand.
I'm very close to textile industry.
I appreciate. In fact, in my closing remarks, I was going to say that while the finance minister has announced a substantial liquidity expansion with the intention to support the trade and industry, the entire intention of the government can actually get defeated if the commercial banks do not start implementing the policy initiatives of the Reserve Bank of India and of course the Government of India. For the commercial banks have a huge responsibility to ensure that loan requests are received, appraised, and disbursements are made. To be honest, I still get complaints from a number of MSMEs saying that the bank managers are unwilling to raise the limit or be more accommodative. And I would actually think the Reserve Bank Governor, Reserve Bank of India, and the FM will have to probably call the bankers and give them very specific instruction saying that they cannot defeat the objectives of these initiatives, and therefore they need to be friendly to customers and then start lending more. I think this is a big worry for everybody. Banks have become risk averse. They are very reluctant to lend, and that has to change. If that doesn't change, I think the entire exercise of the Government of India may not bear much of a fruit. And therefore, I think you should start talking to your banker, which is very, very important.
May I request Mr. or Ms. Kesha? The display name is Kesha. You can ask the question. Kesha. I'll just unmute you. Yeah, now you're unmute. Kesha, you have written that you want to ask a question. Hello? I think the person is not there. Okay, there is another question. What is the limit of service sector company to be part of MSME group? The display name is not clear, so I just asked the question. What is the limit of?
Yeah, the distinction between manufacturing and services has been removed, and therefore there is no specific limit for service sector company. It is all the same for manufacturing and services. Suresh, am I right?
Yes, absolutely.
That's right.
Kesha ask the Hello. Question? Yeah, Kesha.
Hello, hi everybody. So is there any scheme under the stimulate package which will infuse equity in MSME companies? Is there any scheme?
You're not audible, Kesha.
Hello, now can
yeah,
am I
yeah,
audible?
Yeah, now you're audible.
So is there any scheme by which government under the stimulus package, by which it would infuse equity investment in the MSME companies? Like,
yes,
is there any particular scheme?
There is a provision, no? 50,000 crore.
Yes, yes.
There is a 50,000 crore, 50,000 crore equity infusion through fund
yes.
of funds. The 10,000 crore has been provided. And obviously, I think it can rotate five times to become 50,000 crores. So there is a 10,000 crore capital available for infusion of equity. Is this understanding correct? Suresh, maybe you can explain.
Yes, yes, very much right. Fund of funds, jo government of India ka bhi recent, but abhi now detailed guidelines and how it will infuse in equity has not been received. So it is
not
very
received.
Premature to talk on this right now.
Any thoughts, any idea when one can expect this?
I think it will take another 15 to 20 days, what I suppose.
That's not bad. 2 or 3 weeks is okay.
Minimum that.
If it comes sometime in June itself, that will be.
By June end, we can expect.
Right. I appreciate.
Sir, there's a question.
Yeah.
Will 200 crores for domestic tenders be applicable for PSUs also, or is it only for government companies?
Oh, that's a very tricky question. Yes, that's right.
It's a government contracts only.
Government contract, yes.
Government contracts only. Very rightly, very precisely written in that.
Right, yeah.
I hope that
no,
it's answered.
But Suresh, one second. There could be some PSUs where the government has 51% plus stake.
Okay.
And would they not be...
No, all that covers. All that covers. Pardon?
Would they not be considered as government companies?
More than 51 is considered as government company. Very clear.
Government company.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Correct. It may be a PSU, but it's still a government.
Yes, yes. Sir. We are a PSU where 100% is owned
right.
by government. So if we are less than that also, it's government owned.
Samanja. Silby, now it's about 5:25.
Okay.
Can we start? If there are no questions, can we start kind of winding up? I'll make some closing remarks and conclude it. Is that okay?
No, sir, there is a vote of thanks being given.
Yes, perfect. Of course.
Yeah.
After that.
So I'll just request Mr. Saugata Ghosh, Deputy Director General, IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Yes, sir.
One second. I will have some concluding remarks.
Okay.
After that, Saugata will give the vote of thanks.
Okay,
vote of thanks is always the last one. Yeah.
Okay. No, I thought you wanted to.
No. I'm okay.
I'm fine. Please give
perfect,
the closing
perfect.
Remarks
perfect,
on
perfect,
the
perfect,
whole seminar.
Perfect,
what all
perfect.
We had. Yes,
thanks.
Sir. Over to you.
Before anything, I want to thank all my co-panelists for their excellent presentation, sharing their thoughts. Kannan, Bipin Bhai, and of course Suresh. And also, I want to thank all the participants for this. I have some. I want to leave you with some thoughts. As I said earlier, and I've in the last several days, I've done so many webinars that I'm now completely convinced that the only institution that can make a success of the government stimulus package are the commercial banks. And therefore, commercial banks now have a huge moral responsibility to implement the intention of the Reserve Bank of India and the government of India. And if there is any, and I still find reluctance on the part of the commercial bank. And therefore, I would actually think it is now probably the duty of the trade associations, industry associations, chambers of commerce to actually write to the government, write to the finance minister, write to Reserve Bank governor, saying that the banks now need to be instructed clearly to start implementing the package, start disbursing monies, etc. Of course, they'll have to follow all the prudential norms. I'm not saying you throw away all the money, but they need to become quite active now. Otherwise, I think the whole purpose is likely to be defeated. This is number one. for the SMEs and MSMEs and for the Indian economy in general, I just believe there are certain things which are going to happen for sure. One is that there will be faster adoption of technology in terms of, for example, digitization, in terms of automation. I am also expecting blockchain technology to become increasingly popular, particularly for import-export trade. I expect in agriculture, for example, more mechanization, etc. So therefore, automation, digitization, mechanization, technology infusion is something MSMEs have to be prepared. They have to be ready to accept and acknowledge and accept and start using this, number one. Number two, given the health implications of this COVID, my sense is consumers will increasingly opt for healthy lifestyles and healthy foods. And therefore, those MSMEs which are in the food part, the food SMEs and MSMEs may probably will have to probably start looking at producing and selling health foods or healthy foods, because I believe demand for that is going to increase. Those MSMEs which are in the global value chain, there will definitely be structural changes in the global value chain, and already the global value chain is substantially disrupted. Both the domestic value chain and the global chain, they're all disrupted, and this disruption is likely to continue for some more time in my view. I also expect the liberal monetary policy of the Reserve Bank of India, including massive liquidity expansion and low interest rates, relatively low interest rates in India, will continue for a longer time. How long is long time? I can't say, but I'm sure it's not going to change in 3 months or 6 months. I'm sure one can expect it maybe even throughout 2021, that is next year, possible, or even a little beyond, until the economy starts to really gather steam. There is one worry which is there amongst a lot of people. Will countries start becoming more and more protectionist? We don't know, but there certainly are signals that countries could become protectionist, which can obviously distort the global supply chain and the global value chain. And last but not the least, I'm thinking MSMEs now start to think big, and at some stage think of outgrowing their small or medium status. So far, they have enjoyed the benefits of their small or medium status, yes, but they need to outgrow this status and start competing with large industrial corporations. And I'm sure, the kind of entrepreneurship that we have in this country, it should be possible. Pardon me. I think my last thought, I am able to visualize or imagine two scenarios. In my first scenario, I visualize that the pandemic comes under reasonable control sometime in June. It's an assumption. I'm building a scenario. If it comes under control in June, I expect the third quarter, July, August, September, to be a period of adjustment and revival, where banks will have a very critical role to play. So July, August, September, when there is a period of revival, there is a possibility that there will be strong revival, strong improved growth prospects. October, November, December, the last quarter of the year, can potentially see a small rebound in consumption, demand, etc. So this is one, this is one real possibility. The second scenario is very scary for me. The second scenario that I'm able to imagine is a pandemic does not come under control by June, gets extended to July, August, September, etc. Does not come under control. Vaccine takes even more time. In that case, we are set for a deep recession, a prolonged and deep recession, which is a very, very scary scenario. God forbid, we should not get into the second scenario. I'm only hoping and praying that the first scenario plays out. And therefore, because we have to live on hope, and therefore we need, but we should be prepared for the worst. After being prepared for the worst, we start improving our situation and move towards from pessimism. We need to start moving towards optimism and start to revive our business and start to revive our economic activities. So these are two highly plausible scenarios that I thought I will share with you. I will end here and I'll say good luck and God bless you all.
Thank you, sir. As we come to the end of the seminar, may I request Mr. Saugata Ghosh, Deputy Director General, IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industry, to present the vote of thanks. Over to you, sir.
Sure. Mr. R. Kanan, Head of Corporate Performance Management, Hinduja Group. Mr. S. Suresh, Branch Manager, National Small Industries Corporation Limited. And Mr. Bipin Shah, President, Thane Belapur Industry. Mr. G. Chandrasekhar, Director, IMC, ERTF, Economist, Senior Journalist and Policy Commentator, esteemed members of the Chamber, prominent stakeholders of MSME family, exporters, service providers, professionals across India. It is my privilege to propose a vote of thanks at the end of the online seminar of Decoding Government Stimulus Package for MSMEs. I would like to thank the media, electronic and print, who have always supported us by giving a wide publicity to all our programs and projects by spreading them far and wide, the secretariat from the IMC for putting together this lovely program. My sincere thanks to Mr. G. Chandrasekhar, Director, IMC ERTF, for moderating the seminar and sharing his views on the topic. The outbreak of COVID-19 and the subsequent lockdown globally and in India has sparked a huge economic crisis. This has also affected IMC various national and international events, promotional activities, etc., which has been planned meticulously for its members. Under these unprecedented crises, the IMC team has been putting together many virtual conferences and meetings on various issues faced by the trade and industry and have been staying connected with our esteemed members and stakeholders. We have also activated issue of online attestation of certificate of origin, export documents, enabling our exporters of timely clearance of goods at the destination port. I'm confident that India will soon overcome COVID-19 and I assure you to provide our best services and cooperation at all times. Once again, I thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. Yes, Mr. Kannan.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you.